So I think I was at that stage where I was just exploring opportunities, and that's where I came across Pepper. Now I'm not really sure how did Pepper showed up in my LinkedIn feed, but I think I might have applied over there, and post that Anirudh reached out to me on LinkedIn with respect to the similar job opportunity. So I think when he reached out to me, Pepper was a very small team. I think it was approximately only 10 people working there. So I couldn't get a good ref check on LinkedIn because of the limited workforce. But I think what impressed me, and I said yes for the next calls, majorly being that, you know, seeing Anirudh's journey at the same time, knowing that he's similar age and having a company which has started. So I think that kind of intrigued me, and that's how conversations move ahead. To answer that in one line or in two lines definitely might be difficult, because when you are part of a company which is growing at such a massive scale, the tasks just keep on adding. So I majorly work on talent acquisition at Pepper. Along with that, I work with all the operations part of it, with the same time making sure there are labor laws and registrations are in place, and in the end helping with the performance reviews. So this is in nutshell what I take care of at Pepper. Great question. So basically, I think currently Pepper is that stage where, you know, we are defining the culture of the company. And in any company, the initial 100 to 150 employees are the ones who will define the culture for the next 300 to 400. So for us, it's very important that we hire or have people in our team with similar mindset, because that helps in working as well. So the key characteristic, one thing I look into, is their sense of ownership. Because I think working in a startup, no doubt they give you that kind of responsibility, but I think it goes without saying that you should have that sense of ownership. So that's one thing which is very key that we look into. Apart from that, we look into how much willingness of that person to do the work beyond their job, because your work cannot be only limited to your job description. And the willingness of them doing and taking that extra step is something which also helps us in knowing the entrepreneurial spirit in them. So these are two main characteristics we look into the candidates while, you know, we are seeing for the addition of the team. First being, I think that is something which is very common between all that HRs are normally considered as boring people and who abide by rules and processes. So not saying that's not true. Having said that, we are fun people. We also, you know, like to hang out with other teams, and the policies that we create, we want to make sure that we're giving equal benefits to everybody, because in the end, we are also employee of that company. So that's one thing, that the HRs are not boring people. The second being that the human resource team doesn't understand business or the different of, let's say, niche things about business. I think that's something which is incorrect, because while we are hiring, we need to know in depth about the role. So it's my opinion saying that we might know more details about each and every role of each and every team, because that's what we are hiring for. So HR definitely understands the business, because that's how we'll be able to bring the right people. That's one thing. And last being, this is the most common one, that we have a very strong hand in your salaries. Definitely not. It definitely our opinion matters, having said that, the kind of industry experience that we have. But I think whichever your salary you are at, it's a collective effort from all the team, key people in the team or the founders of the company. So we do not have the entire hand in your salary.